Yashwant ji, I'll start with you with Manish's permission, even though he's the author of the evening. In your opening remarks here, you very smartly ducked any political meaning being attributed to this moment by saying ki rajneeti mein dosti to honi chahiye. Lekin sir, kaun manega ki aaj aapne ye jo ye photo op ek hua hai yahan with Arvind ji on one side and Manish on the other, that this does not send a message to your party. Is Yashwant Sinha now well and truly living dangerously? Sir Mike.
Yashwant Sinha is already in the elder statesman category. Now, therefore, I am like a potato, will fit everywhere.
That's another political statement.
No, but let's push you deeper on that. You may self-deprecatingly call yourself an elder statesman, but you are still a very senior face of the BJP, and you're sharing a stage with an Aam Aadmi Party chief minister and a Congress leader. Does this, at the very least, indicate your disenchantment and your disappointment, your disillusionment, and your disconnect with the BJP today? Sir Mike.
I said it right in the beginning of my speech, that this is the basic training, Barkha, that I have received in politics. Please don't forget this.
Please leave it there.
You know, my first leader in politics was Chandrasekhar. And he was the finest human being that I have met. Never allowed any personal predilection to come in the way of his relationship with anyone. The then Prime Minister, Indira Gandhi, arrested him during an emergency. He was in Patiala jail for 19 months. Anyone would be bitter, but I noticed that he had no bitterness in him. And when the accident of that aircraft in which the late Sanjay Gandhi was killed, that met with an accident, he was the first to reach the Lohia Hospital to commiserate with Mrs. Gandhi. Now, these are facts which are history now today, and these forgotten facts must be remembered, that no, we will meet. I will meet Mr. Arvind Kejriwal. I will meet Manish Tiwari. I will meet people from across the political spectrum without any reservations, because if I believe in something, I will not feel compromised because I'm meeting.
Are you worried that this is not going to please your party? It's already not happy with you, with your very scathing comments on the economy, on the finance minister. Now you're sitting with somebody who's always drawing blood with them, Mr. Kejriwal. Manish is not exactly a fan of the BJP. As a senior statesman, even if we give you that, that avatar of the BJP, Mr. Modi and Mr. Shah will not be happy that you're on the stage this evening. Sir, are you?
What did I say there or from there? I said, I'm past caring.
You're past caring, even if your party takes action against you.
That will be the best day of my life.
I have to reconfirm what you just said. I mean, did we hear this right? You said, Yashwant ji, that if the BJP takes action against you, it will be the best day of your life. You said that? Why do you feel that? How did it come to this point?
No, of course, for the simple reason that I don't think I'm doing anything which calls for action. You know, again, going back to Chandrasekhar ji, we were in a political party together. George Fernandez was a very important member and leader of that political party. I remember some state elections where he broke from the party line, George Fernandez, and said he will go and canvass for candidates belonging to another political party with which we were in contest. And Chandrasekhar ji did not take any action against George Fernandez. He continued to be a member. Political parties are voluntary organizations. I did not enter government service when I joined a political party. And therefore, you can't say that taking disciplinary action is the only way out. A political worker is created after a lot of hard work by the leaders of a political party. And if they get rid of a political worker, it should be a sad day for them. Not for that worker.